Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial. So in the past tutorials, we have learned about using many other kind of activities. We learned about many steps in Android app. So taking a short look, we can see that we have learned about the using menu and customizing the UI interface of a Android app. And we also learned about using some other kind of widgets like toast, then snack bar, floating action button, and many other things. So today we are going to learn about using the navigation drawer in Android Studio. So let's get started. We have the Android Studio over here. I'm going to create a new project. By this time we have learned about the empty activity and the basic activity, and we are going to learn about the navigation activity in this tutorial. So by default it is my application. I don't want to change it as it is our test program. So I'm clicking the next, setting all the things are default. And here in this activity window we have learned about the empty activity and the basic activity, and now we are going to learn about the third one, which is navigation drawer activity, in which we have almost everything same as from the basic activity. And the one thing that we get in this navigation drawer activity is that we also get a navigation window, which is actually you can able to get this. Maybe in most in case you may have seen this window, and it is actually something that you swipe from left to the right, and you will see this little pop-up window. Anyway, we are going to select this one and clicking the next, and I just want to change the title into navigation or home. By default, most in case we use the navigation drawer activity as our home activity, so I just want to give it as home and clicking the finish. Now it's take a little time, so I'm going to skip that setup. Okay, so now the build has been completed and we have the project in the Android Studio. So looking into this project, we can see it's almost same as that we have what we have got after the building process of a basic activity. So we have the layouts, activity main, then we have the content main as same as from the basic activity, and we have new two other things. One is the app bar main.xml, nav header main.xml. So these are two XML that we get from this navigation drawer. And just going to the menu, you can see here is a new guy, which is activity main drawer.xml. And also we have where in the values we have where almost everything same. So now what we have to do is let's go to the Java, and we have the main activity, which is actually opened over here. So it's everything is same as from the basic activity. So let's move to the Java, and you can see there are a little bit more codes over here, which is here is the drawer layout declared with the variable name as drawer. And we can see some other little things. It's not that complicated, it's pretty easy, and we have seen most of this codes in these previous tutorials. And here is one of the new code, which is a new method that is one navigation item selector. So this is going to perform when we select a item from this navigation drawer, and finally drawer and some other things. So anyway, let's move to the nav header main file. And here you can see this is how the graphics in the navigation drawer look like. We have a image view, two text views with the different styles. And now let's go to the app bar main.xml, and it's same as what we have seen in many other things. It has a floating action button, toolbar, and our work area. And now let's go to the drawable, and we have a lot of drawable files. And here is one of the new guy, which is side navbar. Let's open that. Turning the preview on, you can see here is different three different colors, and now it's look like a gradient colors. It's not almost a solid color, it's a little bit different one. And this drawable file is going to run on this nav header. The side navbar is going to be the background for this nav header, which is going to be the drawable or the graphics file of this navigation drawer. So anyway, From the next tutorials onwards, we will be discussing about how to customize each and every item of this. So basically, the navigation drawer is used to switch from one window to another without losing this navigation drawer, which means that if you select the navigation drawer item 1, then you can always scroll from left to the right and select that the second item from the navigation drawer. I know that it's not clear for you, but I will be explaining it in detail. So getting started with the navigation drawer activity, I have seen that most of the people were using the navigation activity in a different manner, which is going to be exactly not the way that navigation drawer activity should be used. So what I have seen is that there are a lot of people who are using navigation drawer activity again and again and again just to switch from one activity to another so that they can able to keep using that navigation drawer. The way that the navigation drawer is going to work is just by using the fragments. So if you switch from one item to the another one from the navigation drawer, the only thing that changes is the fragment and not the activity file. So navigation drawer activity is a stable activity which is going to stay as same, and the work area which is going to be the different fragment that we use in this work area, which is this content main and this activity main. So inside this content main, we are going to add different fragment, and according to that fragment activity, we are going to add its corresponding Java file. So in total, what it means is that if you change your activity from one to another, it's only the fragment is going to change and the navigation drawer activity will be stable and it's not going to change. You can able to get the navigation drawer in any activity that you open in this navigation drawer. And we'll be also discussing what is a fragment and how we can create that fragment activity in the upcoming tutorials. I know it's a little bit confusing, so let's take the Google Play Store as an example. In the Google Play Store, we have seen there is the navigation drawer which we use it to switch from the store area into the settings or accounts and many other things. So in that case, we have seen the navigation drawer is still there even if we switch from the store to the settings and accounts and many other things. Even at that time also, there is the navigation drawer, which means the navigation drawer is a freezed item which is locked, and the only thing that changed when we switch from one item to another of the navigation drawer is the fragment. And in case of the fragment, like what we have seen in the empty and many other activities, fragment will contain a Java class and a layout file. As I have said before, we'll be discussing the fragment in the upcoming series. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going to learn about using the items in navigation drawer. And the upcoming tutorials will be discussing about the fragment and how we can able to use it in our Android app. So I hope you guys got a little bit idea from this tutorial, and I'm pretty sure that there will be a lot of questions that you have to ask me regarding this navigation drawer. But anyway, we will be discussing on all other things in the comment section and the upcoming tutorials, and I'm pretty sure that all your doubts will be cleared in the coming tutorials. So thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video.